Hello, welcome back to Wasanini the Historian. Today I will be talking about the Louisiana Slave Revolt, also known as the German East Coast Uprising, which took place in 1811, which is, it's also called the 1811 German East Coast Uprising. And it was an event where many slaves took up arms and attacked their masters. So let's just talk about it right now. So the Louisiana Slave Revolt started in this part of Louisiana called the German East Coast. It borders the Mississippi River, and it started when specifically a slave of Haitian descent named Charles Deslondes started. He actually armed some of his fellow slaves, and they invaded their master's mansion, and then they injured their master, and they even killed his son. But then they went to his basement, they took all of his muskets and ammunition, and started marching all the way to New Orleans. And as they did this, they started burning down other plantations, and they had other slaves gathering around them with whatever weapons they could find, yelling freedom or death. And as they marched through Louisiana to New Orleans, eventually the other more and more slaves gathered around. And the thing is, some of the slaves actually had some experience with warfare. Many of them came from Angola and Ghana, and they had experienced fighting in civil wars in Angola and Ghana. And because of this, some of them actually had some good experience with fighting. Some of them had never experienced fighting and were now fighting for the rights to, well, actually live a decent human life and have the rights to be treated like a human being and not just a slave. So, as they marched to New Orleans, the militias of the slave owners and the U.S. Federal Army actually teamed up, and they actually attacked the rebellers, and the U.S. Federal Army blocked the path of the slaves, and they forced them to retreat. However, the militia actually got them where they were going to retreat, so the slaves couldn't run anywhere. They were slaughtered, and some of them who helped organize the whole thing were actually executed. And this is a very terrifying part of it. A lot of them were decapitated, and their heads were put on poles. And they put these out as a way of telling the other slaves not to rebel, and if they did, they would face the same treatment, and they would face a terrible, terrible death. And whenever I was looking up resources about the Louisiana Slave Revolt, some of the first pictures that came up were like reenactments of it, and some of them were like statues of stuff like that, and I was like, oh. And it's quite disturbing. However, even though this event actually ended in being quite a failure of a rebellion, despite the fact that it was actually one of the largest slave rebellions in U.S. history, gathering over 500 slaves, it did fail, which I kind of already said. But because even though like this was a failure, the fight for civil rights, of course, continued. And in 1865, they finally, slaves who, well, these ones are all gone for the most part. They finally could have the freedom to, well, at least live outside of slavery. However, African Americans still faced a lot of problems. There was actually a form of kind of where people would kind of keep their slaves on their farms without it being illegal, where they would have them on the farms, and they would work for them. They would give them a very small amount of money, but then they would tax their slave. They were basically slaves because they would give them a small amount of money, and then because they taxed them, they had to take that money back. So yes, after slavery was abolished, slavery was still technically a thing. However, people were finding ways to get around it, and eventually, African Americans did actually have the freedom to do more and more things. However, that was only quite recently in the 1960s, which is just incredibly hard to think about. And African Americans still have to face through a lot of hardships and racism and a lot of things to this day. And I think the Louisiana Slave Revolt is a good example of a time that we really did have to have our rights. Like, and even though it did end in a failure, it's definitely an event that we should look into, despite the fact that it's often swept under the rug and not really talked about much. So, in this video, I talked a little bit about the Louisiana Slave Revolt. I talked about a little bit more of African American history after the Slave Revolt and the continuing struggle of African Americans. And I hope to do more videos like this in the future. I will do more videos about African American history. I might do some more videos elaborating even more about the Louisiana Slave Revolt. However, that is it for today. Goodbye.